We shall reflect on the life of Saint Ignatius of Loyola. Baptized Inigo, Ignatius was the last of the 11 children born to a couple of noble descent in the family castle at Loyola in northern Spain. Following a military career, he was seriously wounded at the siege of Pamplona and during a long convalescence read a book on the life of Christ and the life of saints, which made him realize the hollowness and futility of his own life. He often asked himself, if the saints could do this, why not I? After his recovery, he spent a year in solitude in Manresa, searching for God's will, and then made a pilgrimage to the Holy Land. He was already 33 when he took up the study of Latin among the schoolboys of Barcelona, and later devoted 11 years to philosophy and theology at various universities. At Paris, where he took his MA degree in 1535, he was able to attract 6 young men to his way of life. A life of mortification, poverty, and spiritual exercises. Among them were Saints Peter Faber and Francis Xavier. Paul III, under whose direct obedience the 7 placed themselves, looked upon these diligent, disciplined, and devoted priests as a nucleus of a new kind of religious society, whose well-trained and educated members would fill the urgent need for overcoming worldliness and ignorance and counteracting the untruths being spread by the Church's enemies. After the approbation of the Society of Jesus in 1540, Ignatius was elected general and composed its constitutions, which excluded the customary monastic habit, common devotional exercises, and the singing of the office. Instead, its members were to devote all their time to preaching, hearing confession, giving spiritual exercises, and educating boys in schools and colleges. The Jesuits, as they came to be popularly called, grew rapidly in number and were soon conspicuous in all the towns of Italy, caring for the poor and the sick, preaching in the streets, explaining Catholic truths in simple, direct language, and insisting upon the frequent reception of the sacraments. The other countries of Europe felt their influence too, and in the foreign mission field, they appeared in Africa, America, India, and even Japan. At Ignatius's death, the 16-year-old society already counted about 1,000 members and over 100 houses. An implacable foe of Protestantism, the seeds of ecumenism were nevertheless evident in his words. Great care must be taken to show forth orthodox truth in such a way that if any heretics happen to be present, they may have an example of charity and Christian moderation. No hard words should be used, nor any sort of contempt for their errors be shown. Not surprisingly then, one of the greatest 20th century ecumenists was Cardinal Bea, a Jesuit. Ignatius died on the 31st of July 1556, beatified by Pope Paul V on 27 July 1609. He was canonized by Pope Gregory XV on the 12th of March 1622 and declared patron of spiritual exercises and retreats by Pope Pius XI in the year 1922.